Hello, greetings from LokTalks. Today I'll be talking on certain tips on the management of COVID-19.
Namaskar, salam, adab, sat sri akal. Main Dr. Lokesh Bhatia swagat karta hu aapka LokTalks channel par. Subscribe kare professional medical guidance ke liye, spirituality and meditation ke liye aur life coaching sessions ke liye. Thank you very much.
My first tip is that all of us we should understand by now that the COVID virus, coronavirus, is going to replicate in the body maximum by 9th day. So, the point here to understand is if there is any antiviral drugs to be given, should be before 9th day. Otherwise, the purpose of giving antiviral drugs has lost its purpose. Right? So, this was the first point to be understood. The second tip to understand is that the RT-PCR test might be negative in very late stages of the disease. So, the diagnosis is to be made based on the clinical, epidemiological and radiological guidance is the only way to diagnose a case. The best time for RT-PCR after symptoms is from 5th to 8th day. False negatives are lowest in these days. The basic pathology in COVID-19 disease is by inflammation, which is caused by the presence of the virus. It is not per se the presence of the virus which causes the problem. It is the inflammation which it causes. It may produce a severe inflammation in some, or the inflammation might not be invoked in majority. That is why 80 to 90% people are not having any of the symptoms or minimal symptoms or mild variety of COVID-19 disease in majority of people. A lot of variations are there from individual to individual. That is why before getting infection, it is impossible to make out which body is going to mount a serious inflammation. Immunity boosting, yes, is possible. But one who has a boosted immunity, it is very, very difficult to predict. Even the CT changes will occur little late in the disease. The first thing which will change as a response to the presence of the virus in the body is the rise in CRP and LDH. Now let's understand three most important and the most dangerous signs or the symptoms of inflammation. Number one, fever. Number two, feeling of exhaustion, extreme tiredness. And number three is myalgias. So these three symptoms are indicative of inflammation in the body. Steroids and anticoagulation are going to be the mainstay of treatment. So the cornerstone of management of COVID-19 disease is by steroids and anticoagulation. At present, steroids are recommended for the people who become hypoxic. Start early steroids, irrespective of hypoxia, if CRP and other inflammatory markers are high. Oral prednisolone, 20 milligrams, or tablet dexamethasone 4 milligrams per day for 5 to 7 days will do the job for mild symptoms. Steroids will definitely make a patient feel better. Steroids also prevent the long-term lung fibrosis. Well, there is some controversy regarding when to start anticoagulants. So the anticoagulant should be started if there are significant CT changes. Better to start it early if the CT changes are seen, as the changes in the CT are actually microvascular thrombi. After 5 days of giving a course of anticoagulant injectable, one can switch over to oral anticoagulant, that is rivaroxaban, 10 milligrams once a day for 4 weeks time. Well, the steroids may be needed for 2 to 3 weeks time if significant hypoxia is present. Preferable to prolong anticoagulants for 6 weeks if oxygen is needed. Monitor CRP, D-dimer every 2 to 3 days when patient is in hospital. Any significant rise of interleukin 6 on day 5 and day 8 is indicative of cytokine storm. Now, this interleukin 6 can return to normal by starting steroids and anticoagulants. So, the most dangerous period is between 8 to 12 days time. And that is the time when most of the deaths have happened. There are rare reports of cytokine storm after 12 days. But if the treatment is started early, as mentioned above, it is very unlikely that the patient will land up in any complications. Well, as we said, it is the inflammation which kills, not the virus. So hit inflammation harder and early and be alive for 2 weeks time. The body will clear the virus automatically after 2 weeks time. Prone ventilation for 18 hours a day will make a difference if the patient is hypoxic. No need of CT chest after the baseline workup has been done, unless the patient has unexplained or sudden desaturation or worsening all of a sudden. Chest X-ray every 3 days is sufficient to monitor the progress. Remember, the radiological changes can take weeks to months to clear. Don't get panicked. Remember, they are blood clots, not the regular pneumonia. Well, the next important tip is the improvement in the oxygen saturation is the marker for clinical improvement. Same way, if the patient starts deteriorating, the desaturation of oxygen desaturation happens, that is the clinical deterioration. That is the only indicator that the patient is improving or deteriorating. So, oxygen saturation remains the fundamental hallmark of management of COVID at home or in the hospital. Now, if the oxygen saturation starts improving, no need to monitor anything else once oxygen starts improving. If tocilizumab is given, keep monitoring procalcitonin levels. For secondary infections and the risk of infection is present or for even next 2 weeks. So, either the tocilizumab should not be given. If ever it is being given, then remember that it makes prone for development of secondary infections. So, remember this point. Once tocilizumab is given, the patient doesn't mount any high blood counts or any of the inflammatory markers or markers of infection. So, monitor only the counts procalcitonin to detect early sepsis. Keep a low threshold for antibiotics if tocilizumab is being used. As I said, it makes it more prone to develop secondary infections. Don't forget dexamethasone is highly pro-diabetic. So monitor the blood sugar levels before giving dexamethasone or any steroid for that reason. At home, one can make use of glucometer, the medical gadgets which are mandatory to have in any family, every family I've already spoken about. So even if the initial sugars are normal, keep monitoring blood sugar levels, as with steroids, the patient may become diabetic. So as long as the patient is on steroid, regular monitoring of blood sugar levels is mandatory. The next important tip on this management is 10 to 15% of patients don't develop antibodies post-COVID. Reason for it are probably some truly don't develop antibodies or develop some T-cell immunity or a dominant IgA antibody response in the respiratory mucosa and non-systemic IgG response. So the post-COVID immunity passport is invalid. That's why we have come across some reinfection incidences. So be aware about all these tips. One should be aware about all these important tips in the management. Thank you very much. Lastly, the most important point about remdesivir, that remdesivir has been helping the medical fraternity only in reducing the duration of hospitalization. Neither remdesivir nor tocilizumab are any, these antiviral drugs are not at all life-saving. Life-saving medications are only two, that is steroids and second is anticoagulants. So these are the mainstay of treatment. Now, of course, if the patient is desaturating, oxygenation is required. Once the saturation is maintained, only steroids and anticoagulants are the mainstay of treatment. Thank you very much. All the best. God bless you. Take care.